And welcome to the Ramsey Center for a Thursday night rivalry showdown between the Western Carolina Catamounts and the Appalachian State Mountaineers. If you remember, in 2011, a year ago, the Catamounts upset the Mountaineers here at the Ramsey Center in a 3-1 contest. It was the first time the Catamounts came away with a victory at home against the Mountaineers since 2008. Tonight, the Catamounts look to repeat that feat and make it 2 years in a row the Catamounts have beaten their foe from the other side of the mountain here at home. This year, Appalachian State and Western Carolina, they both feature a senior duo defensively, and they're in the top 10 respectively for digs for their school. For the Catamounts, it's Morgan Cochran with 343 digs this season. That's 5.2 a set. In her career, she has racked over 1,200. For the Appalachian State Mountaineers, Courtney Ryan has done a fine job as well. 314 on the season for her, 498 a set. As she is third in Appalachian State history in that category. But tonight, they will be trying to lead their teams to victory in the volleyball battle for the Old Mountain Jug. It is also the Catamounts Dig Pink game here at the Ramsey Center on a Thursday night. Ladies and gentlemen, are your starters. I'm Kyle Rush. Pleasure to have you along with us this evening as we get set for the Catamounts and the Mountaineers on the volleyball court as we will now pause for the national anthem. The pregame festivities are over. It's time for volleyball here at the Ramsey Center. The Catamounts Mountaineers getting ready to do battle yet again. The Catamounts on the season are 6-13 with an even 2-2 record in the SoCon, coming off of a 3-0 win against the Spartans of UNCG. Appalachian State, their last time out, they also played the Spartans of UNC Greensboro and weren't as fortunate. They came out behind on the wrong end of a 3-1 draw. It should be a dandy here in the Ramsey Center, as it usually is, between the Mountaineers and the Western Carolina Catamounts. Catamounts offensively, you got to talk about Nazario, who's usually setting up Caitlin Pachota on the outside with a lot of firepower in that left arm. Nazario, a freshman, has done a phenomenal job for the Catamounts this year in that setter's position. But the Mountaineers with Morgan Ryan, a strong contingent defensively, as we mentioned earlier, some hitters of their own to keep note of as we go through this game. Lindsay Sways, 161 kills on the year, so it'll be interesting to see as the battle for the old Mountain Jug volleyball style is about to get underway. Opening it up will be Lauren Brown for the Mountaineers. Swing it over, Pachota, her right to Ryan. She does what she does so often with another dig, but the attack from the Mountaineers is wide. It's 1-0 in favor of the Catamounts.
Back to serve the Catamounts, number 3, Nicole Ford.
Nicole Ford will lead the serving duties for the Catamounts here this evening against the Mountaineers. Serve comes across, tough one for Ryan to handle, but she does. Deep attack coming, and it's a beauty. Off the hands of Jordan Timmerman, and we are even at 1. That's an area of Jordan's game that she's worked to improve on, especially on that back line, the high attack. And for the most part of this season, she's done a good job of that. Ryan now to serve. Sets it up. Here comes Pachota. Ryan to the dig. Swing it over off the Catamount block, but Nazario can't quite get to it. Addie George and Tina Nazario were there for the Catamounts, but they couldn't quite handle it, and the Mountaineers have a 2-1 lead. You gotta like the play of this Catamount front line, though. Getting pieces of attacks early. Speaking of getting a piece of an attack, Appalachian State sends one home packing. Jessica Ely, the junior from Kansas City, sent Catamounts number 5, Addie George, attack packing. It's a 3-1 Mountaineer lead, and the type of start they were looking for on the road here in set one. Deep attack, Timmerman, still a tough play for the Mountaineers, into the net, and the Mountaineers can't get to it. A strong attack, especially from the back line, from Jordan Timmerman.
Number 6, Tina Nazario.
McConnell comes out. Nazario to serve as Scroggins. Another outside hitter for the Catamounts comes in, and Nazario aces up the Mountaineers. A very impressive serve that time. And a trend you'll notice that goes with saying as a kill that time by Ellie for the Mountaineers. The errors for the Catamount, service errors and attack errors, when they limit those, this team has proven to be very tough to beat, even against some really elite competition this year. Scroggins, the attack, and that's a big reason why. And they're gonna say it's just a tad long on the back line, but with strikers and outside hitters like Abby Scroggins, Jordan Timmerman, and Caitlin Pachota, a lot to like offensively for a young Western Carolina team. Pachota's blocked, it comes right back to Timmerman. She can't handle. So a good early start if you're an Appalachian State Mountaineer fan. The Catamounts down 6-3 here in set number one. Swing it over, Pachota. That is off the block. Give her her first kill. And they cut the lead to 4-6. And now Pachota will go back to do the serving duties for the Catamounts. Serve is away, Ryan Fields cleanly. Maybe some miscommunication there from Appalachian State. Offensively, George tries the lob. Appalachian is there, strike alongside. Scroggins, the dig, fielded by Cochran. Ryan may have helped the Catamounts there. Long attack, Pachota gets enough of it. Mountaineers will get a free ball. Off the block, Cochran is there. And a long rally, still going. An incredible dig by Ryan that time. Timmerman, she'll finally put it down. 5-6, and what a rally that was, Ryan. A couple really crucial saves. Mally for the Mountaineers. Megan Mahoney couldn't quite get it down on the outside. But that was some pretty volleyball. Catamounts trying to even things up, and they will. Ryan unable to get it back across, and the Catamounts have reeled off three straight. It all started with Caitlin Pachota's first kill, and she's gone back to serve, and the Mountaineers haven't had a point since. Pass comes far side. Pachota, nice field. Cochran will pass it back to her. Long attack. Ryan has no problem with it. Nice strike from the Appalachian State Mountaineers. On the outside, that was number 7 in block. Lindsay Sauls, their leading kill getter this year, and it gives the Mountaineers the lead. Timmerman, no doubt as she blazes that one. Right down the left-hand side. And she ties this set up with authority. We're even at 7 apiece. Cochran serve, quick attack and driven home. Ellie, the junior from Kansas City, again on the action. We've said her name a lot in the early going here in set number one. As Saul's back to serve, Cochran a tough field, but she does. Scroggins, long attack off Saul's. And Western Carolina, again, will leave it at 8. Back and forth goes these two. As McCullough goes back to serve for Western Carolina. Set across off the block, Cochran a nice dig. Lob from Ford. Mountaineers are ready for it, but it creates a free ball. Ford that time didn't lob. As she buries it right in front of number 5 in block. Megan Mahoney, the freshman, got a taste of Nicole Ford, the Catamount freshman, a battle that is sure to take place over the next 4 years. And that error will give the Catamounts a 2-point lead. 2-point lead, Catamounts. Swing it over, blocked. Denied was number 8 in black, Lauren Brown. As it was Ford and I believe Nazario over there on the block and stuffed it home for the Catamounts. Another block, this one out of bounds. Mountaineers get a much needed point. They cut it to 11-9. As Timmerman got a lot of it but couldn't quite keep it in play. And miscommunication's gonna cost the Catamounts here. Pachota, along with Cochran and McCullough on the back line, and none of them quite sure who was supposed to field that ball. Here it comes again. Cochran will field this time. Swing it over Timmerman. And she has come out on fire and delivering fire to the Appalachian State defense. By our count, that's her third kill. Unofficially so far in this first set. Swings it across, the Catamount block again, getting the job done, allowing Pachota to try. And another block by Ellie, who's doing a good job defensively. For the Mountaineers, even a couple nice kills for her as well early on in this one. Serve comes across, long field, Cochran. Ford drives it home. And the Catamounts early on, one thing you had to really like is a balanced attack. You've seen a lot from Timmerman, a little bit from Georgia now. Ford slammed that one home. Pachota a kill as well for the Catamounts. That one is long. And once you get a piece of enough of the Appalachian State attack, they hit over it and they hit over everything that time. As a block defensively for the Catamounts, clearly in the Mountaineers' head. Ford again the serve. That one is blasted long. And a free point for the Mountaineers. Ryan to serve for the Mountaineers. Her team down 12-14. Swing it over. Timmerman long attack off the tape. Might have helped Appalachian State's cause. Sauls hits it, but she misses a cross-court shot long in Western Carolina. Lead back up a 3, 15-12, set number one. Nazario had a service ace last rotation around. She tries it again and almost got another one. Appalachian State won't get the ball back over the net, but a teardrop serve that just dies once it comes over the tape. Timeout, Appalachian State. We'll take one with him. Catamounts lead 16-12, set number one. And we welcome you back to the Ramsey Center. Nazario will continue to serve for Western Carolina, her team up 16-12. Appalachian State seeing if they can get a run going coming out of this timeout. Catamounts look to finish set number one. Swing it over Ellie again. She has kept her Mountaineers in this set, both offensively and defensively, as she checks out as Megan Mahoney will come in to serve for Appalachian State. Ready, one, take Serve right to Timmerman. Pachota the lob. And good job by Sauls that time getting in position. But the attack is long, so good job defensively from Sauls. Is all for naught as the attack is long and an unforced attack error there for the Mountaineers. Pachota, nice serve. Ryan Fields. Into the block. George Timmerman denying at the net. 18-13 Catamount lead now. Pachota swings it over and all sorts of miscommunication on the Mountaineers' part. Ryan and Lauren Brown almost clobbered each other in the middle of the Appalachian State defense. The ball went to the floor and it's a 19-13 Catamount lead. Swing it over. Sauls trying to get her team back in the game. Cochran gets the dig and sends the free ball over. Appalachian State, they got to take advantage and they do. Paige Brown, another talented freshman for the Mountaineers, puts it to the floor. And now we'll go back to serve. Her team down 19-14. Long attack coming, Timmerman. Sauls will have her hand at it and is blocked by Scroggins and George. George again with Timmerman this time. Timmerman the block. And it leads to a Catamount point, 20-14. As they have really started to dominate here in set number one. Cochran goes back to serve, enjoying a 6-point lead here in set one, 20-14. And it's even more impressive when you think about the start that Appalachian State got off to early in the set. That one's denied. Sent back across, Sauls will try. Pachota the dig. And Ford puts it down. Pachota only with one kill, but she's doing a good job defensively and definitely still bothering the Mountaineers. And it's opened up the way for Jordan Timmerman and Nicole Ford, who have come out swinging for the Catamounts. 21-14, Appalachian State again will take a timeout as they try to find any way possible to get back here in set number one. And we welcome you back. Catamounts take the floor, and they should be eager to do so as they have really started clicking in the middle part of this set. 21-14. Kills coming from all over the place for the Catamount offense. Defensively, they have looked more than sharp as Sauls has had a tough time going for the Mountaineers, and only the second service error for the Catamounts here in this set. Cochran commits this one. And Sauls goes back to the service line, trying to get that service error from the Catamounts to help get her Mountaineers back in the set. Swing it over, Scroggins, none of that. Number 12 in pink, the senior drives it home. She's looking to make it two in a row against the Mountaineers. 22-15 as McCullough goes back to serve. Catamounts had a strong run last time she was back there. Serve clips the tape, swinging around, blocked, but out of bounds. It is the big 6'1 sophomore for Appalachian State, Dalton Tolliver, who was able to make the play for the Mountaineers there. Now she goes back to serve. Nazario sets it up for the lob. Nice play defensively getting there, but a double hit. Another error by this Mountaineers defense. Some of their youth starting to show here for the Mountaineers as they trail 23-16. And a few errors have helped them get there. Rhine swings it over, long attack. Cochran had none of it. Pachota. Deep attack to the back line, off the block. Cochran tried to go to the floor to get it. Credit a nice Appalachian State attack that time. I believe that was Brown who got the kill for the Mountaineers. Or team down six. Nazario pass forward. Is it off the block? They look at each other and confer, and they say Ford's ball just went out of bounds. No deflection from the Mountaineer defense, so 23-18 now. Mountaineers trying to find a way back into set number one. Pachota, nice field on the serve. Here she comes down the middle. Nice dig that time. Again, it was Tolliver. Pachota again. Off the net and not a Mountaineer defender. 23-19. Appalachian State, 3 points in a row. And only down four now. Four. Had enough of that. Drilled a rocket right at Lauren Brown, and there wasn't much she could do about it. Set point for the Catamounts. Ford now back to serve and get the Catamounts off to a big 1-0 lead. Ford serves Ryan Fields. Swings it over Ellie. The dig, and a tough play as Pachota crashes into the net. And again, it'll be set point, but this time the Catamounts won't be serving. It'll be off Ryan serve for the Mountaineers. Catamounts trying to set up an offensive attack. Ryan serve across. Pachota will field. Now she comes outside, uses that left arm. Ryan, a set saving dig. The lob, Pachota was ready for it. Battle at the net between Ford and Sauls. Sauls was able to get the better of it. But Cochran the dig bails out the Catamounts. Ryan again, another dig, a whistle. And the point will go to the Catamounts as Appalachian State went across the line under the net. Give the point to the Catamounts, 25-20. Your Western Carolina Catamounts take a 1-0 lead over the Appalachian State Mountaineers here at the Ramsey Center. Come back for set number two when we return to Catamount All Access presented by TV62.
Thank you.
Welcome back to the Ramsey Center. Athletic Director Randy Eaton looking on as his Catamounts have taken a 1-0 lead over the Mountaineers. And they look to do the same here in set two. Both teams back out on the floor after they switch sides. The Mountaineers struggled a little bit offensively, especially in the middle part of the set. And Morgan Cochran, again, was a big factor defensively for the Catamounts. But strangely enough, offensively for the Catamounts, you're not talking about Kaylin Pachota. And it's only one kill by our count in that first set. However, she had a few really big digs defensively and some great passes to the likes of Nicole Ford, and Jordan Timmerman had a few strong kills as well. A well-balanced pink zone attack for the Catamounts has resulted in a 1-0 lead here at home against the Mountaineers. And a very energized group as they come onto the floor for set number two. Jordan Timmerman will serve, who had a big time first set for Western Carolina. Timmerman serve, Ryan will field. And Ellie mishandles it in an easy free point. Appalachian State, I'm sure that was a talk of Ginnipro, their head coach. Limit freebies for this Catamount team. Long strike, almost clean out the official. It's too long, Catamounts 2-0. And a quick start for Western Carolina, but remember, it was the Mountaineers in set number one that started out strong. Gotta keep it up throughout the duration of the set. Long attack coming, a nicely hit ball that time from Spurgeon. Pachota, she's in the kill column. And set number two, much earlier. 3-0 as she delivers that cross-court shot. It wasn't her fastball. Saving that for later in the set, maybe. And just a little slider right across court. Still got the job done. How about that? Thread the needle. Spurgeon again. The sophomore for Appalachian State trying to step up here in set number two, and she makes it a 1-3 contest. Here in set two, her team down 1-0. Ryan the serve. Cochran fields. Ford. From the Nazario pass, and that has been oh so effective. Ford has had an absolute field day on this Appalachian State defense. And I think a lot of that has to do with the game plan against Kaylin Pachota. They shift the defense her way and make someone else beat you. So far, Nicole Ford has done just that. Ellie the lob, McConnell, a nice dig. Pachota passes it back. Timmerman, a nice strike. Battle at the net. Catamounts will get a free ball out of it. Here comes George off the block. Sauls has to send a free ball off a poor pass. Pachota. Ryan, a nice dig. Sure-handed on that back line is the Appalachian State senior. Nice lob, George. And miscommunication again will cost the Mountaineers. Catamounts have surged to a 5-1 lead here in set number two. Appalachian State looking for a spark from somebody. Anybody to get going. Long run. Got to get this one across. Sauls does. Timmerman will field the free ball. Nazario, Pachota. Point, Catamounts. CP10 from the far corner gets the job done right in front of Courtney Ryan. And the Appalachian State senior is talented, no doubt, but that one might have been undiggable off the left arm of Kaylin Pachota. Serve in. Give the ace in the back corner. It's a Catamount purple storm. And Appalachian State will call a timeout, 7-1. And the Catamounts in set number two have struck the Appalachian State Mountaineers with an early black eye, 7-1 Catamount lead when you come back. Welcome back to the Ramsey Center. As you can see, a 7-1 Catamount surge to begin set number two. Ford will continue to serve for the Catamounts. Appalachian State, hoping that timeout will help solve this Catamount onslaught to begin the second set. Serve off the tape, and when it rains, it pours if you're the Mountaineers. The bank off the tape is open for Nicole Ford, her second ace here in this service set. Or service rotation, rather. Ford, no ace here. Sauls finally gets Appalachian on the board. And using her vocal ability, as Sauls trying to fire up her team off an absolute firecracker kill for her. 8-2, her Mountaineers trail. Zimmerman looking to answer back off the block. A nifty play from Maddie George. George blocked, and they're going to say she scooped it. And they're going to call a double hit, which off the block. Coach Karen Glover's not going to like this too much, and I think she may have an argument here. That ball was off the Addie George attack. It was blocked back to her, and she fielded it, and they called it a double hit. Pachota battled at the net. Tough pass for her to have to handle. Sends a free ball over now. Long run. Sauls. Tip. Block. What hustle. It's Jordan Timmerman who comes to the rescue on the back line. Lob. Timmerman again. Battle at the net. Off the net. And finally, the Mountaineers will get a point. Jordan Timmerman all over the place defensively. But a big point for the Mountaineers nonetheless. 4-8, they trail. Pachota fields this one. Now she's going to get a chance to finish it. Off the block. Mountaineers rally off another one. And an Appalachian State run now. Their block has been very effective as well. Led by Dalton Tolliver, that ball is in. Appalachian State, all of a sudden, has bounced back. They're only down two in set two. Glover, a quick message to her team near the baseline. Long attack, Timmerman. Ryan steps in. Firecracker from Sauls. McCullough, an incredible dig on a 100-mile-an-hour fastball. Again, Cochran can't get to that one. Tolliver sends it down in. A timeout coming as Appalachian State has fought nearly all the way back. 8-7, your score. The Catamounts hanging to a set two lead.
Farm Bureau Insurance, auto, home, life, health, for over 50 years. Allison Outdoor Advertising, signage and billboard company of Western North Carolina and North Georgia. For over 50 years. Airmark, for a delicious meal before, during, or after the match, visit Airmark at the concession stand. Best Western when you come to see the Catamounts play. All proud sponsors of Catamount Volleyball and Western Carolina Athletics.
Welcome back to the Ramsey Center. A good crowd on hand to witness this one here at the Ramsey Center between the Catamounts and the Mountaineers. Mountaineers are on a tear right now. Catamounts look to end the run out of the timeout. George, Ryan, the dig. Another attack. That one is wide. Timmerman tried to thread the needle and almost did it from the back line. But the Mountaineers have tied things up. Pachota, Nazario. Back to Pachota, the lob. Sauls gets there, and it's deflected off Keller. and into the referee stand. So the Catamounts,
regain
the lead, 9-8. They have never trailed here in this second set. Jumped out to an 8-2 lead. A good rotation for Appalachian State has gotten them back in the set, and a block. Scroggins. And I believe George was in it as well. Catamounts back up by two. Nazario, a tough serve for Ryan to handle. She does. What a pass. Courtney Ryan sets up Sauls beautifully. And an absolute missile sent through the Catamount defense. Not much you can do defensively there. Serve, Timmerman thought it might be out. Late reaction, but she does get it, and the Catamounts get it back across. Swung around, Cochran, another impressive dig. Timmerman from the back line. Mountaineers will try again. Cochran digs it again. Swing it across. Cochran again. Keeping the point alive. Pass. Timmerman off the block. Mountaineers field. This time it's Timmerman just out of the reach of Nazario. And Appalachian State again will tie the set. This time at 10. Swings it over. Scroggins off the block. You better believe it. 11-10. Catamount's not going to let the Mountaineers get a lead that quick. The senior steps up as the sophomore Pachota goes back to serve for the Catamounts. Set it up. Sauls denied this time at the net between Scroggins and George. They'll try the other side and have a little more success. Spurgeon, the sophomore, puts it to the floor. Again, we're tied here in set two. Interesting. Both sets have featured a team jumping out ahead early. It was the Mountaineers in set one, the Catamounts here in this set. Mountaineers lost that first set as they struggled in the middle portion, and the Catamounts dominated from there. How will this set pan out? We're tied at 11 apiece. Timmerman lob. Spurgeon is there. Free ball though for the Catamounts. Nazario, another dandy of a pass. Scroggins finishes it off. Scroggins, two kills and 3 points. As Cochran goes back to serve, and the Catamounts look to extend a 12-11 lead. And Spurgeon gets a revenge, 12 all.
Back to serve for the Mountaineers, number 17, Dalton Tolliver.
As Tolliver will go back to serve for the Mountaineers. At 12 apiece, Mountaineers looking for their first lead in set number two. Nazario pass, and they'll get their lead. As they say, Nazario landed on the other side of the line. Mountaineers, their first lead in set two comes at 13-12. After the Catamounts had an 8-2 start. Ford off the block, tied at 13. Well, if you're the Catamounts, you were looking for someone to answer the bell on that point. The Mountaineers had just gotten their first lead of the set. How are you going to respond to a little bit of adversity? And Nicole Ford did it beautifully on that last point. Catamounts now looking to regain that lead. Not to be had. And again, the Mountaineer offense delivers. Lauren Brown. And talk about dealing with adversity. This Mountaineer team did that after a little bit of a collapse in set number one after an early lead. And they dealt with a Catamount onslaught to begin set number two as Pachota ties things up. Back seemingly against the wall to a 2-0 deficit, and they fought back, and we're at 14 apiece here in set two. Timmerman the serve. Sets up. Guess who? Spurgeon again. And the Mountaineers again take a 1-point lead. Back and forth we go now here in the second set. Ryan will serve for the Mountaineers. Short serve, Cochran was ready for it. Rosario pass over Pachota, nice placement. Ryan was there, but not for the follow. Ford and George causing all sorts of problems. Or beg your pardon, Pachota was in there on the front line. As Ford will go back to serve, we're tied at 15. Ford the lob. Pass backside, tough play for Sauls. The ball was behind her. Misplayed ball from Nazario. That is something we have not seen much of out of the talented freshman setter. And the Mountaineers again lead by one. Nazario helps save this point, however. And Timmerman doesn't disappoint from the back line. Again, tied at 16. Back and forth go these two here in the middle part of set number two. The Catamounts trying to head to the locker room with a two sets to none lead. Strike, Sauls. She's trying to prevent it. She finds the back corner. 17-16 Mountaineers. Ever since the 12-12 mark, no team has won two consecutive points. They have been trading off points on each other's serve ever since. George, the strike, long run for the Mountaineers. They'll have to send a free ball over. Nazario sets up Pachota. Off the block. Appalachian State now with a chance. Timmerman saves it for the Catamounts. Pachota sends it over. A strike. It's through everything. And they're going to say it was tipped at the line by Timmerman. And again, Karen Glover off the bench, encouraging her defense as they need a point here down two. Scroggins delivers. The senior delivers. And crunch time for the Catamounts, 17-18. Pachota back. This rotation did work early on in this set and also at the end of set number one. Lob coming. Nobody on the Catamount defense expected that from Tolliver. 19-17 now. Mountaineers lead. Saul's back to serve. Serve comes across. It's a good one. Cochran was there. George attacks at the high point, but mishandled off the block. 20-17, an absolutely huge point for the Mountaineers, and Glover knows it. Timeout, Catamounts. They trailed 20-17 here in the second set. We'll see if they can rally when you come back to Catamount All Access, presented by TV62. Welcome back to the Ramsey Center, the Cathead. The tunnel here for the Catamounts that they look to hit ahead two sets of love, but if they're going to do that, they need to find a way to get back in this set, a set where they once led by six, now trail by three. Saul serving for the Mountaineers. Pass from Nazario, Timmerman off the Mountaineer block. And into the net. That time goes Spurgeon, who has exploded in the middle portion of this set for the Mountaineers. This time, she's unable to do so. Catamounts back within two. pass coming long attack, and Nazario was ready for it. But it forces a free ball. Again, a long attack. Cochran, a nice dig. Nazario sets it up. Lob. Ryan saves the day for the Mountaineers. And off the block of Ford and Scroggins, it'll find the empty spot on the floor. Timmerman was going to her spot defensively in the deflection. The ball went to the spot where Timmerman had just left. Scroggins, strong attack, but the ball comes flying back. Pachota now. Ryan is there. Long attack, that is good on the baseline. Right on the line on the far side. And the Mountaineers have their largest lead of the set at 4. Off the tape, here comes Timmerman. Ryan, a nice dig. Punch over, the Catamounts were there. Pachota, the play defensively. Strike, Cochran is there. But nobody for the Catamounts can get to the ball. 23-18 now. Back and forth they go. And now, for the first time tonight, Callie Pfeiffer will check into the game, a 5'11 freshman from Wake Forest, North Carolina. Pfeiffer sets this one. Mountaineers are able to field and through the Scroggins block. It'll be multiple set points for the Mountaineers. Really have to credit the way they fought back after trailing 8-2 in this set. Much like the Mountaineers, started ahead in the first, and a double hit on the pass will end set number 2. We will head to the locker room, a set apiece. Catamounts took the first, 25-20. The Mountaineers took the second, 25-18. It's shaping up to be a dandy in the battle for the old Mountain Jug on the volleyball court here in a Thursday night matinee at the Ramsey Center on Catamount All Access, presented by TV62. Welcome back to the Ramsey Center. We're tied at a set apiece. The Catamounts looking to rebound here in set number three after falling in set number two. An interesting note, whoever storms out the fastest does not win the race in the set. Appalachian State had a 6-2 lead in set number one, lost 25-20. In set number two, the Catamounts had an 8-2 lead, lost 25-18. We will see how that storyline pans out as we continue here at the Ramsey Center on a Thursday night. Mountaineers, Catamounts looking for another dandy in a rivalry heated battle on Catamount All Access, presented by TV62. If you're just joining us, Catamounts are in the pink uniforms today. This is their annual Dig Pink game. And looking to mine a little gold as well by digging out the Appalachian State Mountaineers and sending them further into the Southern Conference hole. They are 1-3 on the year. Catamounts trying to make them 1-4 when they leave the Ramsey Center here tonight and seal their fate further into the cellar. They're tied with Elon at the moment at 1-3. Your North Division leader in the Southern Conference is Samford, a perfect 4-0 conference record, followed by the Spartans at 3-1, Chattanooga and the Catamounts at 2-2, and the Phoenix and the Mountaineers currently sit 1-3. On the south side, you got College of Charleston, a 4-0 record. Georgia Southern sits 3-1. Furman and Davidson at 2-2. Wofford and Citadel both looking for their first conference win on the 2012 campaign. Here at the Ramsey Center, it's one apiece set-wise as we get ready for the second half of our match. Caitlin Pachota looks to get going for the Catamounts in front of a nice crowd here at the Ramsey Center. Even covering the tops of the rafters, some of them, as we are underway in set number three. Cochran sets it up. George looking to strike first. A nice dig. Scroggins off the block. She's there. George, the lob. Ryan fields for the Mountaineers. And that time, Appalachian State's Lauren Brown will strike first. Will it be a blessing or a curse here in set number three? Nazario swings it over. Pachota, long strike. Give her the kill. Right in front of Courtney Ryan. Even at one apiece as Pachota now will go back to serve. Sets it up. Ellie was blocked. Good recovery from the Mountaineers. Pachota again. Ryan almost collided with Spurgeon. A nice block. Denied. Scroggins at the net along with Jord. Sending it back home. 2-1 Catamount lead here in set three. Pachota, long back pass. Ryan have to give over a free ball. Battle at the net. Cochran now will pass. Pachota takes advantage. Ryan there for the dig. And another block. Ellie denied this time. George, not only did she block it, she sends it back with authority. 3-1 Catamount lead here in the third set. Now they hope the trend of quick starts and sets reverses and it leads to a set win. Another block. The Catamount line is dominating. Three straight points. The Appalachian State attack hadn't left the top of the tape as it's three times in a row been sent back packing by Scroggins and George. Lob serve from Pachota this time. Attack coming. Battle at the net. Appalachian State will try it again. Lob this time. Scroggins. Nice dig that time from Brown. Pass comes over to the Catamount side. Nazario, George, and I believe she got into the net. She did. It'll be a point awarded to the Mountaineers, 4-2. Catamounts on top. Ryan now to serve as the blocking brigade for the Catamounts has gotten them a 4-2 lead. Nazario pass, Timmerman. Appalachian State showing they can do some blocking of their own. Kelly along with Ellie in on the block that time. Junior and freshman combo for the Mountaineers. They inch to 4-3. Pass right over the top of the block. How about the set so far for Addie George? A couple of huge blocks and now a kill. As Cochran will go to serve a Catamount 5-3 lead. Pass comes, Saul's blocked. Scroggins fired up. A double clutch pump from her as she high-fives her teammate and blocking comrade that time, Nicole Ford. Lob Saul's again, this time she finds a way to get it through the block and off the Pachota dig. Attempted 6-4. As Mahoney will serve now for the Mountaineers. Ball comes across. Blocked by the Mountaineers. 6 apiece now. Serve. Nazario tees it up for Scroggins, who misses long. Now tied at 6 apiece here in set number 3. And a missed pass is sent back with authority. Keller, and now the Mountaineers have the lead, 7-6. Back and forth they go here in the third, and Glover, a quick word to her team on the baseline before the serve from Mahoney, who serves it into the net. A giant momentum killer for the Mountaineers. McConnell now to serve as Scroggins has a chat with Glover as she checks out. Long run. Finally finds the deck in between Timmerman and Ford. Mountaineers back on top, 8-7. Third set already has that back and forth feel to it. And an early 7-8 score. Ford off the block. It's high enough for the Mountaineers to be able to recover. Saul's the lob. Timmerman, fist save. McConnell. And just misses. From up here, looked like it might have caught that tape. Tough to tell from our angle. But at any rate, it's a 9-7 Mountaineer lead and a service error again. Will help halt momentum for the Mountaineers. Twice the Mountaineers have either gotten the lead or extended the lead this set. And now the block will tie it up. The block has been in full force. Nazario and Ford that time. Here in set number 3 for the Catamounts. It's got to be the fourth or fifth that's led to an immediate Catamount point. Timmerman the serve. Swing pass, another block. Catamounts not quite able to field it as it was off Ford's fingertips. And Sauls will serve it for Appalachian. Her team up 10-9 here in set number 3. Nazario tees it off. Ford drives it into the net. A mistake there as she tried to drive it off the Appalachian State block. And it's 11-9 Mountaineers. Nazario will try it again. Pachota, is it off the block? No. A groan from the crowd as they thought it might have been. It's a Mountaineer three-point lead. Their largest lead here in the third set at 12-9. Cochran fields the Saul serve. Pachota, the lob. Will miscommunication. Appalachian State recovers though. Blocked again at the net on the deep attack. Another block from Nazario and Ford. They'll lob it over the head this time. It'll set up Ford. A lob of her own. Finds the floor. A big point for the Catamounts. 10-12, they trail.
Back to serve the Catamounts.
Had to find a way to stop the Mountaineer run, and Nicole Ford did just that as she goes back to serve. The serve comes. Nice dig by McCullough. Timmerman off the tape. Miscommunication all over the place. Catamounts draw within one. Timmerman just got it over the tape, and it confused the Mountaineers on the direction and trajectory of the ball, and three ended up in a similar spot, but none of them able to come up with it. Ford tried the short serve, and that a killer for the Catamounts as it misses short. Sets it up, George the lob. The lob's starting to create points for the Catamounts. First forward, now George. McCullough with a pep in her step as she checks out. And Scroggins comes in. Catamounts down one, Nazario serves. Tough play, and Ryan wasn't able to field it cleanly. Pachota trying to tie it up. A nice dig that time by Spurgeon. Nazario again, clean set, Pachota, Spurgeon again, a phenomenal play. Trying to catch the Mountaineer defense off guard, a block. They go into a scramble, it's a Catamount point, we're tied at 13. apiece here in set number three. Another dandy of a serve from Nazario. Cochran, a nice dig, allows Timmerman to get under it. Pachota sends it over. Another block by the Catamount front line. Scroggins punches it over. It's good enough for a point. Catamounts rally, two straight points. Timeout, Mountaineers. The Catamounts have stormed to a 14-13 lead. Don't go anywhere, folks, on Catamount All Access. This one's a dandy here on a Thursday night matinee at the Ramsey Center. Welcome back to the Ramsey Center. A thunderous rally for the Catamounts has given them the lead. 14-13, set number three. Tied at a set apiece and a pivotal set to say the least. The winner of this set can try to clinch the match in set four. The loser will have to win two straight, and Ellie delivers for the Mountaineers. We're tied at 14. Brown to serve now for Appalachian. Nice serve, Pachota fields. Timmerman, the lob. Appalachian not fooled this time. Long attack, and I think Cochran got just a piece of it, which might have th- thrown off Nazario, who was diving to the floor. And now the Mountaineers have answered with two of their own. And now they lead 15-14. Brown serve. Nazario sets it up. Here comes Scroggins right down the pipe.
Boy, Webster.
A bullet sent right from the middle of the Catamount attack. 15 apiece as Pachota goes back to serve. Nice pass, and that is long. Point to the Catamounts. And first, the Catamounts struck with two, took a 14-13 lead. Appalachian responded and took a 15-14 lead. Now the Catamounts have responded. It's 16-15 in favor of the Catamounts off the block. Timmerman pokes it down, and that one is wide. Western Carolina now up a pair. 17-15, and this has been a phenomenal set to watch if you're just joining us. Back and forth, some really high-quality volleyball here in the Ramsey Center between Mountain Rivals, and there is some lack of high-quality volleyball from the Mountaineers. A poor pass, poor communication, and a Catamount three-point lead. Ellie, again, the story of set number three has been the Catamount blockade. This time it was Scroggins and George. George has been all over the place in that department in this set. See if the brigade continues. Catamounts now lead by four, 19-15. See if they can close it out when you come back to Catamount All Access, presented by TV62. Welcome back to the Ramsey Center. 19-15, Catamounts lead, set number three. Pachota back to serve as the Catamounts have a four-point lead and have done it with a block brigade at the front line here in this set. Scroggins wide off the attack as she tried to go baseline. A big-time point that time for the Mountaineers. And now they're only down three as Courtney Ryan goes back to serve. Back and forth they go here in set number three in a one set apiece contest. Free ball coming for the Mountaineers. Can they take advantage? Ellie drives it home. She does. 17-19. A big point. This is the first meeting between the two rivals this season. The second will come November 1st in Boone at Appalachian State. Catamounts looking to get ahead in the season series with a win here at home, which would be the second straight at the Ramsey Center against Appalachian. Timmerman a miss hit. It's three straight now for the Mountaineers. The lead is down to one. What an atmosphere for a college volleyball match. Two rivals going at it here at the Ramsey Center. Back and forth they go in a tight match in the third. Nazario, Timmerman. We have a whistle, and I believe the Catamounts will get this point. They will. Appalachian wall went onto the other side of the line with their feet as they tried to defend a Timmerman attack. Cochran serves it away. An impressive dig, to say the least. Battle at the net. Appalachian State finally wins as Keller initiated the attack, but I'll tell you this, Lindsay Sauls gave it everything she had, and Cochran was somehow able to control it on the dig. Nazario, a poor pass there, miscommunication, I think. And she thought Scroggins was coming on the backside. We're tied at 20. A crucial stretch here. A pivotal third set. 20 apiece. Timmerman, it's wide. Mountaineers lead, 21-20. Another big point, they're all big. Now the rest of the way in this set. Another good serve, Timmerman long attack off the block, Ryan is there. A dagger of an attack that time from the Mountaineers. Timeout, Catamount says. Tolliver put that one to the floor, 22-20. Catamounts need a run when you come back to Catamount All Access, presented by TV62, and we got a dandy for you. 22-20, Catamounts trail in the third. Welcome back to the Ramsey Center. Jordan Timmerman looking to give her team a boost and push them over the top for a big third set win. Right now her team trails 22-20 here in the third set. Mahoney serving for the Mountaineers. Timmerman right away gets some action as she fields. Now she'll come on the attack. Long run for Ryan, but she makes the play. Sauls, deep attack, Pachota the dig. Tough play, Nazario for the lob. It's a good one. It's a great one. The Catamounts get the point as Appalachian State couldn't quite come up with the goods and knocked it under the net. Now McCullough serving to try to get the Catamounts back square here in set number three. In what has been a very entertaining back and forth battle in this set, that one, a missile, it's long. It went through the back line, and as hard as it was hit, it was tough to see. But just outside, we're tied at 22. Lob, a block. Off the block this time, Cochran's able to get the dig. Timmerman near side, she's been a big factor offensively. Sauls. Pachota had none of it. Timmerman the lob. Battle at the net, and Appalachian State hit it. Catamounts go back in front, 23-22, a big point that was. As she reached over, and I believe either made contact with a Catamount player or the net. I think she got the tape. And that one is just wide. As Cochran nearly aced up the Mountaineers to create a set point. Next point vital. Whoever wins this upcoming point will have set point. Serve comes across. Pachota. Ford. Ryan able to field it. Appalachian with an attack. Block. Battle at the net. Sauls. Block. McCullough. What a save. Point still alive. Nazario. Ford. Count it. One. The crowd erupts. And true, it's a set point for the Catamounts to go up 2-1. What a play by Paige McCullough. A stick save, to say the least. Set point for the Catamounts. Timmerman the serve. Ryan will field. Lob. Catamounts here with a chance. Pachota the lob to finish. It comes back. Timmerman will play it. Pachota again. Attack this time. Long run. Sauls will give it a try. Off the block. We're tied at 24. A close call, I'm sure, for Sauls, as many a time in this set has that block come right back at her. Now, 24 apiece. Next point will also result in an upcoming set point. Serve, Pechota Fields. Here she comes on the attack now. Another nice dig by the Appalachian defense. That was Mahoney. Blocked this time as Appalachian scrambling just a bit. Battle at the net. And a whistle. Some of the players stop playing, and Appalachian State will get the point. And I don't know exactly what the call is. I think a catamount may have gone into the net. So Sauls will serve for a Mountaineer set point. Can the Catamounts now stand tall? Serve comes, a tough play for Pechota. She gets the job done. Butler, or I beg your pardon, forward on the lob. Tried to poke it through. Pechota was there. Appalachian State in a chance. Nazario tees it off forward down the middle. Another nice dig. Brown was there. Cochran answers. Pechota, nice attack, and Mahoney the dig. Long rally and a block. The story of the third set keeps the Catamounts alive in it. Ford, Nazario denies set point for the Mountaineers. 25 apiece in a classic third set in a huge rivalry matchup. Nice play there. Ford goes to the floor for the dig. Pechota cross court, counter. Set point number two coming for the Catamounts. As Kayla Pechota, who's been sort of quiet in the kills category, comes up with a big one there. 26-25, Ford serving for the set. Tough play coming over the top. Catamounts field battle at the net. Ryan recovers for the Mountaineers off the block. Pechota punches it in the air. George the lob, count it! No, the ball is still alive. The crowd thought the set was over. And it's blasted long. Is it off the tip? Yes! Catamounts win the set, 27-25, and now the crowd can explode. 2-1, Catamounts lead. And you have a feeling that that set is huge and pivotal. We will take a timeout. Catch your breath for the fourth. Catamounts lead 2-1. We'll try to put it away on Catamount All Access, presented by TV62. Welcome back to a bubbling, sizzling atmosphere at the Ramsey Center. The Catamounts found a way to win the third set. They lead 2-1. Now, can Appalachian State respond? Or will the Catamounts close it out in as dramatic session as fashion as they did the third set? It has been back and forth all night long. Nothing makes you believe it'll change now. 2-1. Catamounts trying to put away the Mountaineers by the same score they did here at the Ramsey Center a year ago. Nazario will start it off from the service line here in the fourth. Mountaineers field, swinging it across. Nazario now will set it. Back, Cochran in a nice dig that time. Pachota looking to get involved in the offense a little more than she has been. Ryan, a nice dig though for the Mountaineers. Again, she'll try. Ryan again, the dig. Lob off the George block. Mountaineers will strike first here in set number one. Courtney Ryan now will serve as Spurgeon checked out for the Mountaineers. Now it's Ryan at the service line with the Mountaineers up 1-0. Nazario, back set, George. Double hit. Ball had a lot of spin on it, tough to play. And they touched it twice. On the pass attempt, now Pachota will serve, tied at 1-1 here in the fourth. Lob is a dandy loose ball. No, the Catamounts saved it. And it finally put away on the corner as everyone on the Catamount side was bunched together trying to save that last play. And the Mountaineers were able to find the open corner and put it there. After an incredible play by Morgan Cochran, 2-1 Mountaineers lead here in the fourth. Nazario pass to Pachota. Long attack this time for the Mountaineers from Mahoney. Timmerman. Now come the other side, Pachota the dig. Set it up, Jordan Timmerman the lob. Back and forth, a long point here. Momentum to whoever gets this one for sure is back and forth they go. Off the block, off the tape, and out of bounds to the Mountaineers. 3-1. And it looked for a moment that it would come off the tape in play, but it kept riding it all the way out of bounds, and a 3-1 Mountaineer lead. Nazario swings it over. Timmerman, a absolute laser. Appalachian will scramble to get this one back across, but they do. Nazario, George is blocked. And it's the Mountaineers who have stormed out to a 4-1 lead. Here in set number four, in a do or die set for them, trailing 2-1. Scroggins, long pass over for Timmerman. It was a good one. Nice pass there, but Ryan spoils it with a dig. And just like the third set, Scroggins and George combine on a big time block. The blocking game for the Catamounts in that third set was phenomenal, and they get one here in the fourth. And that time the Mountaineers go right through the block, 5-2. And that's one that George and Scroggins will probably try to shore up, or Ford rather, close that gap between the two of them. Scroggins puts it to the floor. Might have gone off the tape. McConnell will come in to serve for Scroggins. Catamounts down 3-5 here in set number four, up 2-1 in the set count though. A block again. This time it's Ford and Azario. That time they did close that gap right between the two of them, and it results in a Catamount point, 5-4 now. McCullough served quickly. Looked like a miss hit there from Sauls. Don't see that often. Pachota did not miss hit it. Caught Ryan off guard, and Pachota, big kill. It seems when the spotlight gets brighter and the points get bigger, Pachota always finds a way into the scoring column. Cochran fields an absolute rocket. And what about that place? Jordan Timmerman giving Appalachian all sorts of headaches here in this match, and she does it again there. Holy cow, there's some pace down there on the floor. Really fun to watch. A very impressive dig from Ryan. Nazario Ford off the block. Saved Appalachian State. Another bullet that time from Sauls. Timmerman blocked, but she recovers. And then Spurgeon puts it through, 6-all. Some really high quality stuff here tonight. The fans that have come out have been treated to an absolute fantastic match thus far. Fans here hope it results in a Catamount win here in the fourth to close out the match. Cross court passes wide. Catamounts take the lead, 7-6. Remember, they were down 4-1. Catamounts on a 6-2 tear. Timmerman to serve. Long into the block. Pachota and Ford were on that one. Now Pachota on the attack off the tape. Ryan able to get there. McCullough, Nazario tees it up for Pachota. Again off the block. Mahoney that time. On the dig, Nazario, tough play, and it's blocked right back at her as she tried to make a tough play going into the net. On a initial pass, it was a little too far, and we're tied at 7. Pachota. Nice dig that time on the back line. And McCullough gets knocked to the floor on a very impressive tack from Spurgeon, who has had herself a very nice game indeed for the Mountaineers. Pachota passed too far. Ellie made her pay. And just like that, the Mountaineers go up 9-7 here in the fourth. A big point there. And a big bounce back for the Mountaineers after the Catamounts have taken the lead. Pachota in between Ryan and Tolliver as she placed it beautifully. 8-9. You gotta like the placement from Pachota. Has a lot of pace in that arsenal, but she's also able to find her mark, an area she's really improved in from a year ago. McCullough again. Just wide. Appalachian State somehow survived that point, and McCullough almost again spoiled a fantastic attack effort for the Mountaineers. Substitution out as Keller will come in for Appalachian State. Brown to serve for the Mountaineers, who are up 10-8 here in the fourth. Tough ball for Pachota to handle. A little upset with herself. And it's 11-8 Mountaineers. Their equals, rather, their largest lead here in the fourth set. But leads of this size have been proven to evaporate in this match. The earlier lead that the Mountaineers had in this set evaporated once already here in this set. And now the Mountaineers starting to get on a roll. They finish the long rallies. They poke it by McCullough. 12-8, their largest lead here in set four. Another tough ball on the serve, Pachota. An incredible pass from the back from McCullough. A block, it's out of bounds. Appalachian up five, and that will lead to a timeout. We'll take one with them. Appalachian State doing what they have to do and come out to a good start. 13-8 here in the fourth. Mountaineers lead, trailing 2-1 at the Ramsey Center on Catamount All Access, presented by TV62. Welcome back as Lauren Brown, the junior for the Mountaineers, has served a little bit of a problem for the Catamounts, a 13-8 lead, and she has created some problems with that serve that has been very effective. The Catamounts have fielded this one, though, and now we're in the middle of a rally. A nice block there. Mountaineers will try again. Cochran the dig. Nazario pokes it across. A scramble they're able to field. Ryan the pass, and it's a beauty. The attack equally is impressive. And Brown again will get to serve. Pass comes across. Nice lob, George. Ryan there. Cochran, a nice dig. Catamounts really need a point here, down 6 in the fourth. Set across off the block. Cochran yet again there. Nazario tees it up. Pachota blocked. Cochran trying to save it, and she can't do it. 15-8 at on a roll. Lead is 7. Catamounts took a 7-6 lead since then. It has been all Mountaineers. A 9-1 run. Pachota trying to end it. A misplayed ball off the tape, and an interesting way to end the run. Spurgeon thought that was out, and it landed right over her head. Inbounds by a good 8 inches or so. Now Nazario trying to have a rally, much like Brown did for the Mountaineers. Serve is wide, but not more than a fraction off on that baseline. Ryan now to serve. A 16-9 lead. They try to keep that or extend it here on this rally. If you're the Mountaineers, if you're the Catamounts, you try to find a way to cut into it and get a rally on your serve, and it's a service error. Ryan might have tried to get a little too cute right there on the sideline. On that far baseline, and it was wide. Now Pachota to serve. It's a rotation that Glover likes. Nice block. Teed up from Nazario. Nazario again tees it up. Scroggins couldn't get to it. Off the Cochran scramble, 17-10. And if this trend continues, we will head to a fifth and final set if Appalachian State is able to pull it out here. Nazario for Scroggins, looking to keep the Catamounts and get them back in it here in set number four. And if you're Appalachian State, you can ill afford to let Western Carolina get back in this set, because not only would they have a huge amount of momentum, when they smell blood, they would go for the kill, literally and figuratively, as they trail by six as of now here in the fourth set. Nice set. And an even better dig defensively. Pachota made a nice play there. That one really hot to handle. And it went off Cochran. And the Mountaineers again bump the lead back up to seven. Ford mishit it. Spurgeon made her pay for it. Now, an 8-point lead. The Mountaineers six away from forcing a fifth. 19-11, a poor play there by Timberman. And Glover's going to take a timeout. 20-11, the Mountaineers, with their backs against the wall, have responded. 2-1 Catamounts lead, but the Mountaineers have a 9-point lead here in the fourth. When you come back to Catamount All Access on TV 62. Welcome back to the Ramsey Center. Catamounts desperately need to get a rally going. If they want to try to close it out in the fourth, they trail by nine as of right now, 20-11, but we have seen runs be made here in this match. And a big one, most notably, from Appalachian State here in this set. And the tape fooled Jordan Timberman. She thought it was going to come over clean. It did not. And then she misplayed it. 21-11. Ford blocked. Appalachian State feels it now. 22-11. And it certainly feels like we will have a fifth set coming. Timmerman the lob off the block. Nice pass. Again, a nice play. And dig that time. Nice save by Ford. Sauls finds the gap. Pachota, Cochran. And it looks as if to me the Catamounts have maybe put a little bit in reserve to come out here in set number five and take this one in the fifth, as it is multiple set points, for the Mountaineers, 24-11. And we will head to the fifth, one would think. Ford is gonna delay it at least a point. 24-12, and make Appalachian State work for it. And maybe be a little more taxing heading into that fifth set. Another one they must win. Another interesting match fact. It has been back and forth, and no team has won consecutive sets. If that trend continues, it'll be a fifth set victory for the Catamounts, but a quick start in the fifth set will be crucial. We will head to the fifth. First of 15, win by two. And the official will explain the rules and have a brief meeting with Scroggins, and Courtney Ryan, the two team captains. And we've seen a little bit of everything. Appalachian State, early middle of that set, really took control. And it got away from the Catamounts early on in that fourth set. But that was the importance of the third, winning in the way they did. Teams will switch side for the fifth decisive set. And it will prove to be a dandy, as a lot of rivalry games are here at the Ramsey Center. Appalachian State, Western Carolina, toe-to-toe, looking for a Mountain Jug win, volleyball style, on a Thursday night in the Ramsey Center. Welcome back. Catamount athletes supporting, as you see Trey Sumler. Catamount point guard is in the building along with some of the other contingent on the men's squad that will look to do one game better than they did a year ago with a SoCon title, as they fell just short to Davidson. And that tournament will be in Asheville yet again this year, so it'll be interesting to see how their season plays out. And we will have that for you as well on Catamount All Access. Beginning in November, we will also remind you, Catamount All Access will have Catamount football homecoming style this Saturday, as the Catamounts will take on the 8th-ranked Georgia Southern Eagles at E.J. Whitmire Stadium. Kickoff slated for 3:30. Coverage will begin at 3:25 from E.J. Whitmire Stadium here on Saturday afternoon. Here we have a fifth set dandy. The Catamount volleyball team and Appalachian State are in the fifth set. Catamounts came out of the gate, won the first after Appalachian State got off to a quick start. Second set, Catamounts were the ones off to a quick start, and Appalachian State answered. Now, in the third set that went extra points, the Catamounts found a way on the second set point to get the job done. Appalachian State in the fourth with their backs against the wall answered the bell. Now, a fifth decisive set. If you're new to the sport, we played a 15 here in the fifth set. First of 15, got a win by two. As We Will Rock You plays in the background, the crowd hopes to rock Appalachian State out of the Ramsey Center with a loss. And a good crowd on hand. Here in the Ramsey Center, not a soul is left from the ones that were here, enjoying a fifth set classic between the Mountaineers and the Catamounts. As coaches say their last words, teams huddle up on the floor and we're ready for play. Megan Mahoney will kick off the fifth set. I beg your pardon, it's Lauren Brown, number 8. That'll lead it off. Nazario tees it off. Scroggins off the block. Catamounts lead off 1-0. And in a shortened set to 15, a quick start is crucial. The start the Catamounts wanted right there. Now Pachota at the service line looks to extend that lead. Ryan, a nice field. Ellen up the middle is blocked. Missed field. As Spurgeon couldn't get there, it's 2-0 Catamounts, and they've come roaring out here in the fifth. Now Pachota. Serve, and that one is in. A great cross-court shot that was. That was a beauty. from Spurgeon, who has had a very good game for the Mountaineers. Now, Courtney Rhine, who is third all-time in digs for the Mountaineers, will serve. Timmerman, lob. Courtney Rhine, nowhere to be found there. It's 3-1 Catamounts. A nice placement as she put it in between the front and back line, and the tip, I believe it was off Keller, made it a really tough play for Mahoney to try to get there. Sauls, she'll try the lob. Timmerman was ready for it. And off the block, battle at the net. Sauls will send it back. Swing it over, Scroggins. Firepower and a firepower 4-1 lead. The senior stepping up here in the fifth. And in a shortened set, Appalachian State, Matt Ginepro, their head coach, knows that he can't let this get out of hand early. 4-1, Catamounts off to a quick start in the fifth. Welcome back to the Ramsey Center, a 4-1 Catamount lead. Here in the fifth set, they played a 15 win by two. The Catamounts dig pink game, and a big one it is against arch rival Appalachian State, looking for two straight wins against the Mountaineers here at home. Sauls, that is wide, 5-1. Pachota watched it go right by her and right out of bounds. 5-1. As the drama continues to unfold in this classic. Ellie denied at the net. Another block will allow Cochran to get there. Timmerman, Rhine. Off the block, out of bounds. 5-2, Mountaineers inch closer. And a big point there for Appalachian State, as they keep in touch with the Catamount lead, which is a 3. And Appalachian State can't get a run going. Can't win consecutive points. Catamounts answer with a point of their own there. 6-2, McCullough in the ball game to serve. Serve, Sauls. Cochran, a big-time dig. Nazario, can she get a good pass? It'll have to be a free ball. Mountaineers trying to take advantage. Cochran off the block, yet another dig for her. Long run, Rhine will try to get it back. She does. Nazario, pass, Timmerman. Again, Appalachian defense is there. Cochran, a nice dig. Long rally here. Timmerman fires it through. Cochran, a fist pump of emotion. And a big Catamount point. The lead is now 5 here in set 5, 7-2. Here in the fifth, the Catamounts lead. McConnell serves it across yet again. Attack comes right up the middle. Cochran is there. Ford, she's had a nice game today. Nazario for the lob. Maybe not quite as far as she might have liked to play that ball, but point still alive nonetheless. Ryan the dig. Sauls blocks. Ryan tries to save it. It's out of bounds. 8-2. The Catamounts have surged to a commanding fifth set lead as they switch sides. 8-2 Catamounts here in the fifth set. They are over halfway to the finish line here in the fifth. But remember, the Catamounts also had an 8-2 lead in set 2. The Mountaineers were able to come back and win that set. However, this is a shortened set. They go to 15, not 25. Catamounts look to keep it going right at the Appalachian State Mountaineers and slam the door on a big time win on the road.
Continuing to serve for the Catamounts, number 14, Hayes.
As McCullough will still continue to serve. Serve comes across. Wide off the block. Timmerman. She's fired up, and rightfully so. It's a 9-2 lead. A 7-point lead in the fifth. And as much as it looked like the Mountaineers dominated the end of the fourth set, the Catamounts have reversed that on the Mountaineers here in the fifth. And right now, if you're the Mountaineers, it's got to feel like you're trying to stop a landslide. Lob, Nazario, Ford, count it, 10-2. Rack him up yet again. Ford, an absolute firecracker to the back corner.
Timeout, Appalachian State.
Timeout, Mountaineers. The Catamounts adding a black eye to the Mountaineers' hopes of winning here tonight at the Ramsey Center. 10-2, see if the Catamounts can close it out in the fifth when you come back to a dandy at the Ramsey Center on a Thursday night. Catamounts lead 10-2. Appalachian State, Courtney Ryan in the huddle, trying to find a way to will her team back. Her senior year, she does not want to lose on the road to the Catamounts, and Scroggins does not want to lose at home to the Mountaineers. In her final game against Appalachian State here at the Ramsey Center, McCullough to serve. A 10-2 Catamount onslaught so far in the fifth. Cochran the dig. Ford. Ford again will try a crack at it. Blocked back, Timmerman. That's trouble, Ryan can't handle. And the Catamounts are 4 points away, and they are dominating right now here in the fifth set. Appalachian State has to find a big run from somebody, and it's got to start defensively with Ryan. Serve is long. So, that'll give the Mountaineers their third point. They trail 11-3 here in the fifth. Catamounts 4 points away. The Mountaineers hadn't gotten that many in the set yet. They need a big run here. Pachota pass Timmerman. Block, Ryan is there. A big time play from the senior in black and gold. Timmerman the lob, nobody there that time. A little dropsy-daisy for the Catamounts gives them a 12-3 lead. A lob right over the top, and Timmerman has had a phenomenal fifth set for the Catamounts. Stepped up big in the third as well. And this time it's Nazario. 13-3, crowd sensing victory now. And rightfully so, the lead is double digits. 13-3 here in the fifth set. And the crowd is letting the Catamounts know their support as the coach relaying a message over to the Appalachian State official through one of his players as he wanted to talk to Paige Brown, who then went over to talk to the official, and now there will be conference time between both side judges, and Glover is going to come out to the baseline and huddle with her team as the officials sort this out. I'm not sure exactly what they may be discussing here. It's a 13-3 Catamount lead here in the fifth set. Maybe it's just trying to slow down a runaway freight train. And they were conferring about the last point. They will continue to give the point to the Catamounts. And again, Paige Brown is over there. Still confronting the officials. Now the crowd's going to start letting Paige know about it. And Brown now will give an explanation to her coach on what they feel is a wrong call.
Continuing to serve the Catamounts, number 9, Jordan.
13-3, Timmerman to serve. And we'll see if maybe that'll spark a little run in the Mountaineers. Block, Nazario. McConnell will send it over. Chance here. Off the block. Out of bounds to the Mountaineers. Spurgeon, a big time point there. They need a lot more of them, trailing by 9. 13-4. Lindsay Sauls, their kills leader on the year, back at the service line. Nazario, Pachota, set point, match point, Catamounts, 14-4.
Back to serve for the Catamounts.
Ford will serve, the crowd on their feet. Cats a point away from sending the Mountaineers home packing with a loss again. In the second straight year. Ford, yes, ma'am, she did it from the back line. 15-4, a Catamount romping here in the fifth set. And the Catamounts win 3-2. They win 25-20, 18-25. 27-25, 11-25, and 15-4 in dominating fashion in set number 5. The Catamounts improve their conference record to 3-2 on the year and move into third place in the Northern Division. Appalachian State, the Catamounts more than happy to send them to the cellar of the North at 1-4. And 5-14 overall for the second straight year. The Catamounts win at home against the Mountaineers from Appalachian State. They'll head to the dark side of the mountain, a little darker in the standings. Catamounts, a big time win, their second win in a row, as they look forward to taking on Davidson. I'm Kyle Rush for all our TV62 crew. Thanks for joining us here on Battle for the Old Mountain Jug here in the Catamounts Dig Pink game. Catamounts beat the Mountaineers in 5 and an absolute dandy for all our TV62 crew. Saying so long and have a good Thursday night, everybody.